The past few years, the Jordan 1 was probably the most popular Jordan brand shoe. And this year, at least in recent memory, it seems like that trend has shifted to the Jordan 4. We just saw the Jordan 4 Bred reimagined. Really pleased with that shoe. Probably going to be, I think definitely going to be, in my top 10 sneakers of 2024, even though it's still very early. And Jordan Brand's following up with another Jordan 4. And this shoe is actually inspired by the Jordan 4 Metallic Pack that released in 2020, which was inspired by the Jordan 1 Metallics. So this Jordan 4 is inspired by another pack that's inspired by something else. Air Jordan 4 Metallic Gold. The shoe is dropping on March 9th for $200 in the United States. This is a women's exclusive. And first impressions of the shoe, obviously kind of reminiscent to the off-white Jordan 4s that everybody loves. Also kind of reminds me of the Jordan 4 Frozen Moments from 2023. That was a women's exclusive as well. I think that was a pretty nice looking shoe out of the two. Probably like the more subdued silver kind of chromatic look than this very shiny gold, but I think both are pretty clean. And the materials on the shoe, it is leather, and the leather does feel pretty nice, especially in the toe box. It's pretty soft, does seem to have like a matte finish. It doesn't have that annoying plastic coating that you see on a lot of shoes, that shiny plastic coating. I really don't like that. So still feels pretty nice to the touch. I don't mind the materials on the shoe. Now, of course, the most distinct thing about the Jordan 4 is the wings and the plastic parts, as well as the netting that you see on the upper sole. For this shoe, the wing specifically, that is leather. The plastic lacing parts, even though it does look shiny and bright, that is just cheap plastic as well. The gold is very reflective, very bright. It might look more expensive than it is, but yeah, in hand, you can feel how cheap it is. And now moving up to the tongue, usually for a Jordan 4, you'll see like a Jordan Jumpman flight tag on the top of the tongue. This one, it's actually debossed into the shoe, and I actually think that looks pretty cool. And on the inside of the tongue, you get an upside down Air Jordan tag. This began on the Jordan 4. I have to mention this every time I get an upside down Air Jordan tag. Jordan Brand originally started doing that because back in the late 80s, people would wear their shoes with their tongues flipped inside out. So they anticipated it, made the tongue upside down. So when they did this, it'd be the right side up. And on the booty of the shoe, in the more vanilla and cream color, it is the very familiar Jordan 4 back tab. This comes with a Jumpman, of course. Isn't an OG colorway, so you can expect a Jumpman, only very special collaborations and OG colorways. Has a Nike Air branding, but this one, just a Jumpman as you would expect. And this Jordan 4 heel tab, it is like regular Jordan 4s, not like the SB Pine Green Jordan 4s, where the heel tab was super bouncy, super soft. This one, just like a regular Jordan 4. Usually, I don't love when they stick like this vanilla, kind of more yellow color on shoes, where it's like a white upper sole and in that color for just no reason, or like sale midsoles where it doesn't really make sense. But this shoe officially, it is sale, so it's not supposed to be like a clear white on the upper sole. So just for comparison's sake, this is definitely more of like an off-white cream color. So I do think this palette makes a bit more sense than like a sale midsole and like a black upper sole or a green upper sole, and they just go with the pre-age nonsense for no reason at all. This combination, I think, makes a bit more sense. And one thing to point out, this vanilla look, this cream color, it's not too yellow, so it doesn't look like pee, so that's always a bonus. And of course, everyone's very interested in the shape of Jordan 4s recently. This one, I don't know, it still kind of feels a bit too boxy for me, not as sleek and slim as the Jordan 4 Bred reimagined. I thought there were rumors that they were going to go back to like the original toe box of the Jordan 4 going forward, but yeah, still looks a bit boxy to me. I don't think it's perfect. I don't think it's perfect. And the Jordan 4s comes with a polyurethane midsole with a visible Nike Air unit on the heel, as well as a Nike Air unit on the forefoot. Now, what's interesting about this midsole, you'll see this glossy finish over it, just making this shoe shinier and shinier. Very glossy finish. Not sure if I love that. And of course, a beautiful outsole, herringbone traction, and the same vanilla cream color with a Jumpman in the cutout. Not Nike, just Jumpman. Not an OG colorway. Another place where you'll see that gold is on the insole of the shoe. And the insole, Dream Style insoles. Now this shoe doesn't come with any extra laces, just these laces out of the box. I think it works. I always appreciate extra laces, but these work just fine. Imagine gold laces. Gold, like shiny laces. Box of the shoe, a Jordan 4 box, Jumpman flight. The flight concept was first introduced on the Jordan 4. And now moving on to sizing and comfort. I am a wide footer for Jordan 4s. I usually go up half a size to size 10. Now for wide footers, the sizing for Jordan 4s is just Yeah, it's not easy. Jordan 4s are already notorious for being super uncomfortable. So when I go up half a size, there's a bit too much wiggle room in the toe box or the heel. However, it does give my toe box much more relief. If I went true to size, that toe box area, that pinky toe, it'll just crush me. It'll absolutely crush me. But I will say, for whatever reason, I feel like this Jordan 4 out of the box is not as stiff as like a Jordan 4, like the Jordan 4 Thunder, or like a Jordan 4, what is it? That one up there. That Jordan 4 Navy, that came super stiff out of the box. This one came much more comfortable. With that all said though, there are still a lot more comfortable Jordan shoes than the Jordan 4. This is known for being not a very comfortable shoe, but relatively speaking, I think this is a more comfortable Jordan 4 than some other regular Jordan 4s. The Jordan 4 Bred Reimagined that we just saw, as well as the Jordan 4 Pine Green SBs, those are exceptions. Other Jordan 4s, at least in recent memory, those are not very comfortable. In terms of the cushioning and tech specs, I think it works well. It's very old Nike Air units on the forefoot, as well as the heel, a polyurethane midsole, which is a little bit of weight savings. So it's not too bad, but it is very old. And for whatever reason, even though I think officially the 4s are lighter than the 3s, that just feel like a more clunkier shoe. It really just does. And that means the total sole score of the Jordan 4 Metallic Gold, the 29 out of 40. Pretty average score compared to other general releases. Now in terms of the colorway, I think there's a very nice colorway. It's very clean, it's very simple. Maybe a bit too simple, maybe a little bit boring for some people, but yeah, overall, a very nice colorway. Not much to complain about. Doesn't get me like super excited. I prefer other colorways like the Bred, like the Chicago's, UNC, Oregon, Michigan colorways, Georgetown colorways. But this one, you can't really complain. Majority white. I know it's not officially white, but for all intents and purposes, sale or white, you can't really go wrong with it. In terms of the materials, I think this is pretty nice leather. It's pretty soft to the touch, but these gold pieces, yeah, might look shiny, but it's anything but. It is anything but cheap plastic. In terms of the comfort for this specific Jordan 4, I think it's more comfortable than recent Jordan 4s. Apart from the Jordan Bred Reimagined, as well as the SB Pine Greens, it just feels less stiff, feels less boxy, doesn't kill my toes as much as other Jordan 4s. Yeah, I think this is a relatively more comfortable Jordan 4. Now, in terms of versatility, Jordan 4s, I think, are one of the more wearable and versatile shoes on the market right now, at least in terms of Jordan brand shoes. Super easy to wear. It's probably the most popular at this moment, but super easy to wear, super versatile. And look at this colorway. You can't really get more easy than this. Pretty much a white sneaker. The gold is maybe, some people consider it more feminine, the shiny parts. The gold is maybe a bit too loud, a bit too bright, a bit too bold, but yeah, I think it's still super, super easy to wear. It is pretty hard to follow up the Jordan 4 Bred Reimagined. I think that was a very, very nice shoe. Obviously, your legendary colorway by now, an OG colorway. However, a lot of people are predicting this is the year of the Jordan 4. It is the most popular Jordan brand silhouette right now. I think they did a pretty good job on this one. I don't think it's everyone's cup of tea. I think in hand, I know it's very cliche, I know it's oversaid, but I think in hand, compared to when I saw it in images, I did think this looked better in hand. I think it looks better on feet, like seeing it in person, than if you try to imagine it from images. So yeah, I think they did a good job. So that's it. Thanks for watching, Sole Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 4 Metallic Gold. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.